Greetings everyone, in this video I will show you how you can use Stable Diffusion X-Large SDXL on RunPod with our beloved Automatic1111 SD Web UI. Moreover, I will show you the way of generating amazing quality images with high resolution fix, and I will also do a speed test on RunPod on a very cheap GPU such as RTX 3090, which is only 29 cents per hour. So if you don't have a good GPU, then RunPod is the amazing solution for you. So I have prepared a very detailed GitHub Readme file. All of the instructions and commands that you are going to need is posted here. I will update this file as it be necessary in future. So just leave a comment to the video and then I will update the file. The link of this file will be in the description of the video and also in the comment section of the video. So let's begin with logging in into our RunPod. If you don't have an account, you can also register. Click this link, go to your RunPod, login. I will start two instances. In one of the instances, I will make automatic installation, and in another instance, I will make manual installation. So type here stable to search for the template. Select RunPod Stable Diffusion template, current Stable Diffusion Web UI 9.1.0. When you are watching this video, it may be higher version. You can increase your volume disk size from here, such as 100 GB or 200 GB. It is up to you. Let's go with 100 GB. Click set overrides and click continue and deploy. Let's go to my pod. Let's click here and rename our pod. One click installer. Let's start another instance of pod deploy. This will be manual. It may take a while for pods to start. When you click logs, you will see the logs of the pod. Click connect, connect to JupyterLab. If you don't know how to use RunPod, I have an excellent master tutorial. The link is here. Please watch it and learn more about RunPod. Okay, we have connected to our JupyterLab. The first thing that you need to do is go inside Stable Diffusion Web UI and change relauncher.py file. Copy this from here and change this line to this one, save it, and then restart your pod. You have to do this one time. This is mandatory. Don't forget to restart. Let's also connect to our manual installation. Let's go inside Stable Diffusion, open relauncher.py file, change this line, save it, and then restart the pod. Why this is necessary? Because if you don't do this, you won't be able to kill the initially started web UI instance. This is mandatory for both automatic and manual installation. Then I have prepared a one-click installer. It is shared in this Patreon post. Let's open it. Download the one-click auto1111sdxl.sh file from attachments. Enter inside workspace. Click this upload icon. Let's go to downloads. Upload the sh file. Then all you need to do is execute this command, copy it, open a new terminal, paste the command and hit enter, and everything else will be automatically done. You will also get this permission denied message, but it is fine, it is working, it is killing the initially running web UI instance. Let's continue with manual installation. Let's connect to JupyterLab. Manual installation is also pretty easy. I have prepared the steps. By the way, if you want to learn how to use Automatic1111 Web UI with SDXL, I have this excellent tutorial. Please also check it out. So first we need to enter inside Stable Diffusion folder. First you need to take a backup of web UI user.sh file, this file, because this file will get overridden. So I will download it, right click and download. The instructions are written here. Then open a new terminal while you are inside workspace Stable Diffusion Web UI. Currently this is where we are. Open a new terminal. You will also see the terminal position here like this. Then we need to do a git stage because we are going to override some of the files. Then do a git checkout master. This will check out the master branch. Then do a git pull. This will update the web UI to the latest version with all of the branches. Then git checkout development version like this. And now we are inside development branch. If you don't know what are branches, let me open the repository of Automatic1111 Web UI. Currently there are 12 branches. Let's zoom in. When you click the branches, you will see when were they last updated. There were release candidate branch, which was supporting SDXL, then it is merged into development branch. When you click the development branch, you will see it is 290 steps ahead of the master branch, when you click the commits, you will see all of the commits and their messages. So whenever you want to update your Automatic1111 Web UI installation to the latest version, you need to use this command and it will update to the latest version. Currently we are at the latest version. Then we will upload back to web UI user.sh file. So while you are inside Stable Diffusion Web UI folder, click upload icon, upload it again, and it will say override yes. Then you need to remove skip install. Why? Because skip install command will prevent the Automatic1111 Web UI from updating its necessary libraries. However, we wanted to update them because we have updated our branch and commit version. It says file changed. Yes, click override, and now we have saved it. Now open a new terminal like this. Now we need to download SDXL models. You don't have to do this setup with automatic installer that I have shared on Patreon, but here we have to do it. First of all, join Hugging Face from here. If you don't have an account, then click login and log into your account. Then you need to accept terms and conditions. They are auto approved. Open these both of the links. When you click the link, it will ask you researcher early access agreement like this. Go to very bottom, fill the fields as you wish. I am filling them with my check this checkbox and submit application. After that, you will be automatically approved. Then we need to generate our tokens. So click this link. From here, let's generate a new token. Test. You can give a name, anything, generate token. Copy the token, open a notepad or any text editor and paste your token here. Then copy this, paste it into same place. What you need to do is change your username to your Hugging Face username. My Hugging Face username is MonsterMMORPG. Then copy the token and change the token here. So it is like this at the end. Then copy entire thing. Then you need to move into the Stable Diffusion Web UI folder inside Models, inside Stable Diffusion, and open a new terminal here. So you see this is my terminal position. Copy paste the command and hit enter, and it will download SDXL base model. Currently we only have 0.9 version, but when we have the newest 1.0 version, I will update the GitHub Readme file. The procedure will be same. We will do the same thing for Refiner. Currently, Refiner is not supported with Automatic1111 Web UI, but I think it will come very soon. So let's also copy this and copy the token. This file also goes into the same folder. So let's open another terminal and copy paste the command. And now we are ready to start using Automatic1111 Web UI. For using Automatic1111 Web UI, it is same after both manual installation and with my one-click installer. This is the command. Let's copy it. This command is also written at the very bottom. The automatic installer were already completed, so I will continue with it. Open a new terminal. Copy paste the command. It will kill the previously running instance. Then it will start a new Web UI instance for us. You see currently it is starting and it has started. We can connect. So let's go back to our my pods. Let's click connect, one click installer, click connect to HTTP service. When you zoom in your Automatic1111 Web UI, now you will get this message. Click here to ignore, and our SDXL base model is loaded. So I have some good prompts in my Stable Diffusion GitHub repository. Please also start it, fork it, and watch it if you haven't yet. These prompts are shared inside amazing prompts list for Stable Diffusion, this file. In the very bottom, there are some amazing prompts, so I will copy this one, paste it here, then I will copy the negative prompt, paste it here. Don't forget to change resolution to 1024 and 1024, and we are ready. Let's generate an image. Let's also look at the speed. We will see everything in the newly started terminal, so it will appear here. I think it is currently loading the model, so still no messages. Okay, you see that we have CPU usage 100%. It is taking some time in the first run, I think. Let's just patiently wait. This is not expected, but we have 100% CPU usage for some reason. Okay, for some reason it didn't start, so I will just stop the pod, start the pod again. I will delete the manual installation because we already seen it. Let's terminate. Once you terminate your pod, it will get deleted permanently. You will lose all of your data. Okay, delete it. Okay, now we got the results. It turns out that this machine was the problem itself. It is not working. Maybe its CPU is broken, maybe GPU, or maybe something else. So I made a quick another installation, and now you are seeing the results in the another installation. Let's make a speed test. So I will make the sampling steps 150 and let it generate. When we open the CMD window, we will see the speed. Since I am zooming in and zooming out, the displayment is like this, but it is generating images with 3.4 IT per second, which is amazing. So I have generated another image with 150 steps to see its speed. This is the generation result. You see it is amazing quality without refiner, and it was 3.33 IT per second, which is amazing. Let's also try with high resolution fix. So I will upscale it into 4 megapixels and let's make the denoising strength 50%. Click ignore and hit generate. Okay, now we see the speed of high resolution steps. The speed of high resolution steps are much slower, 1.41 seconds per IT, but it is expected. Why? Because it is upscaling 1 megapixel image into 4 megapixel image, so it is expected to be 4 times slower. And this machine is a very cheap machine, using only 30 cents per hour. Let me also delete this to show you. Let's refresh the page. You see I am only using 30 cents per hour, and we have amazing image generation speed. By the way, I think this image is going to be an amazing one. Since I made them 150 steps, it is taking huge time. High resolution steps are using same number of steps if you don't define them with your sampling steps. And here we got our results. Let's look at the details. Opening new tab. And amazing. This is the default resolution of the generated image. Just look at the details. These details are amazing. There is some repeating of eyes in here, but this is not a cherry pick. This is the first generation, but the details are just super amazing. You see the quality of SDXL is amazing. It can't be even compared with the SD1.5. By the way, this is also very weird. So how could you get good images? All you need to do is don't make high resolution fix, generate some number of images, then pick the good one and use the same seed. I will show you an example. So I will use batch count 4 and I will make the width of the image 1536 like this. And let's generate forever. Right click and generate forever. I will generate until I get a good image, then I will apply high resolution fix. By the way, it is able to generate 4 images at the same time. The IT per second is 2.2 IT per second. So basically, actually, we are getting 8 IT per second, which is amazing. So let's say you have generated hundreds of images and you want to find the best one. Open a new terminal. While you are inside Stable Diffusion Web UI outputs, the terminal started, then use RunPod CTL send and the folder name, which is this one, copy paste it and hit enter, and it will give us a new download prompt like this. I will download it into my music folder. Let's open a CMD here, copy paste and hit enter, and it will download entire folder into this folder. If you don't know how to make RunPod CTL working, in this tutorial I have explained it. So here are downloaded images. Let's extract it. Here we have images. Let's say I like this image. I am just giving an example. So what I need to do is go to PNG info tab, click here, go to music folder, text to images. You can also alternatively drag and drop the image, or you can also use this method. Open the image. It should load the values. Yes, the parameters are here. Click text to image. It will also load the seed value. Then click high resolution fix. By the way, 2x will not work from this resolution probably. So I will upscale by 40% like this. Let's make the denoising strength 50%. And yes, let's make the batch count 1 and let's hit generate. So we will get an improved version of this image. Let's look at the IT per second. It is 1 IT per second right now. Okay, we are getting a very nice image. This is the methodology of obtaining amazing images. Okay, here the final image. It is improved. Let's compare it. Here we see On the left, the base image. On the right, the upscaled high-resolution fixed applied image. When we look at the details, we can see that the high-resolution fix is very, very good. By the way, I resized them to equal size. So you see from these two, this one, let me also show you its original resolution. So this is high-resolution fixed applied image, and this is the base image. High resolution fix apply it, the base. You see it is amazing quality. This is for all. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you don't know how to use Automatic1111 Web UI, how to use SDXL, RunPod, I have amazing tutorials in my channel. You can look all of them. All of them are very useful. When you click the playlist, you will find also my playlist. For example, in here, we see the SDXL playlist. When you go here, you will see my Stable Diffusion tutorials playlist. It is 46 videos. Please also support me by joining my YouTube channel from here. Subscribe, leave a comment, like the video. Also, if you support me on Patreon, I would appreciate that very much. Your Patreon support is tremendously important for me. I am also posting useful stuff on Patreon, so you won't regret it. I hope you consider supporting me. When you click the about tab of our channel, you will see my LinkedIn profile and my Twitter profile. You can follow me, you can connect with me. Hopefully see you in another amazing tutorial video.